Hey, what's up everybody? In this lesson, we're going to learn how to make a custom depth of field map or depth map using Adobe Photoshop. Now, the outcomes for this are really, really great because you can use this not only for still images, but you can even bring this in to other areas such as Adobe After Effects to get a custom depth of field look. So I'm going to show you two different ways to do this today, and let's go ahead and get started. And our goal is to essentially make a grayscale map that we use to control the blurriness or depth of field to create a rack focus or other types of cinematic looks. So to do this and create this, let me show you the new way first. We're going to go ahead and use neural filters. So I'm going to go ahead and grab the original layer here and go to filter. And we're gonna find the Neural Filters plugin. Now you're gonna wanna make sure you're in the most up-to-date version of Photoshop. I'm using Photoshop 2025 at this point. That's the most up-to-date version. I'm gonna hit Neural Filters and it's gonna open up all of these different filters here. A lot of them, if you're using this for the first time, you'll have to download. It takes a few minutes. Usually they're quite small in megabytes, so it happens pretty quick. But you're looking for the one called Depth Blur. I'm gonna go ahead and open up Depth Blur and immediately you're gonna see the blur applied, but it's a bit overwhelming. So how do we fix that? Well, we're gonna use this interface here to help us. So we can go ahead and, for instance, if I wanna focus on the bird, I can select the bird, or if I wanna focus on the person in the background, I can select that person in the background. And so this is going to give you different focal points to kind of focus on. So once you do that, you can go ahead and start adjusting different elements. Now, if you just want to focus on the subject, you can do that, but you can see it's kind of bleeding into the mountain there. So that one doesn't always work as well. The focal range is just going to be the amount of depth it's going to grab. So you can see here, it kind of grabbed these corners a little bit better. And I'm going to move my blur strength down just ever so slightly. I don't want to like pull that out too much. I just want it to be kind of a soft blur here. We can also mess with things like the tint as well as the brightness. We could add a little bit of grain. And the cool part here is we can actually just output the depth map. So if I do that, it will not apply the depth map or the blur. I would have to do that in a different way. That's the second technique I'm going to show you. So for now, we're going to just go ahead and keep it as it is. And I'm gonna go to output two, and we could do this as a new layer or masked or even a new document. We're gonna keep it new layer. So when I hit go, I now have layer one, which is gonna be my depth image, and there you have it. Now the trick with this image is it is destructive. So this is something that you wanna keep in mind as you're building out using neural filters this way, that you know, as long as I have a backup, that's okay, but again, it is pretty destructive. In this particular case, I didn't have a mask. So how do we get around that in general? Well, one of the options I mentioned when we did the neural filter, and let's go ahead and run that one more time, was to go to the very bottom of the screen and choose output depth map only. Now, if you go ahead and do this depth map only, and you wanna always make sure you check the focal point, that's important. But once we do the depth map only, it's going to essentially export an image that looks like this. Now, this is a really powerful image, and this is a little bit of the old school way I used to do depth when I first started using Photoshop. So I'm gonna go ahead and hide the neural filter way, and I'm gonna go ahead and hit select all on this depth map image. I'm gonna then make sure I do my edit copy, and I'm gonna go to my channels tab. If you don't see channels, you go to window and channels and you'll find them right there and open them up. We're gonna create a new layer that's gonna be black, and then we're going to paste Command or Control V or edit paste that image into that. Now this is called alpha one. Anytime you create a new layer in your channels, it will be an alpha. And I'm gonna click back on RGB, go back to layers and eyeball off that element. Now, a quick deselect just to get everything looking good. Now I have the ability to add a filter to that original image. So we're going to go to filter blur, and let's go ahead and select lens blur. When we select lens blur, it's a bit messy, but we have similar options. So we want to make sure we're using the depth map found in alpha channel one. I like to do the more accurate option. And then just like in neural filters, you can kind of go ahead and select and really play with some of the blur distance and custom regions. Your radius is kind of the blur amount like we did in neural filters, but here you can play with things like the rotation of the blur, the bending, you know, how the specular highlights come in. You can still add a little bit of that noise just to make it a little more cinematic. We can even switch it over to monochrome or Gaussian. So we have the ability to add a little more textural elements and really just pull in that cinematic film-like look. When I'm done, I hit OK, and now I have the lens blur version, and I have my neural filter version, and I have that depth map just in case I need to transfer this over. Maybe I'm creating something in Adobe After Effects where I want to really push the dimensionality of this. And I have other videos that you can watch on my channel that talk about how to use depth maps to really simulate the illusion of 3D. So that's all we have today. I hope you enjoyed this lesson and you can start implementing depth maps into your workflow. Catch you in the next lesson.